Okay, let's go.
Cathy Joel's Autograph Adventures.
Hi everyone, welcome to another episode of Jazzy Joe's Autograph Adventures, India's first web series where I show you the top 10 autographs based on a different theme in every episode. Before we begin, let me thank you all so much for the great amount of love, support and feedback that you have given me for the last 27 episodes. I appreciate all your support and that encourages me to show you many more autographs from my collection on LP Records. Thank you so much. This time we are talking about the top 10 popular sport legends in my autograph collection. These are the people who have dedicated themselves to different sports and have gained love, fame and respect from people all around the world. And our first sports legend and his daughter co-wrote his autobiography titled The Race of My Life. And the book inspired the movie Bhag Milka Bhag, a biographical film of his life. I think you know that I am talking about the great Milka Singh, popularly known as the Flying Sikh. Milka Singh is an Indian former track and field sprinter who was introduced to the sport while serving in the Indian Army. He was the only Indian athlete to win an individual athletics gold medal at the Commonwealth Games until Krishna Punia won the discus gold medal at the 2010 Commonwealth Games. He also won gold medals in the 1958 and 1962 Asian Games. He represented India in the 1956 Summer Olympics in Melbourne, the 1960 Summer Olympics in Rome, and the 1964 Summer Olympics in Tokyo. He was awarded the Padma Shri, India's fourth highest civilian honor, in recognition of his sporting achievements. The race for which Singh is best remembered is his fourth place finish in the 400 meters final at the 1960 Olympic Games, which he entered as one of the favorites. Singh's fourth place time of 45.73 seconds was an Indian national record for almost 40 years. The film Bhag Milka Bhag, based on his life, was widely acclaimed in India and won awards including the most popular film at National Film Awards. Unfortunately, I have been unable to meet Milka Singh ji, but I would like to meet him as soon as possible and maybe get his autographs on the LP record of the movie Bhag Milka Bhag. But I do have him in my autograph collection in the form of this photo. You can see it's a beautiful photograph, a black and white photo. And his name is written and the Flying Sikh is written and he has signed with a red marker writing with love Milka Singh 5th June 2015. Our next sports legend, a tennis player, won her first professional singles title in Orlando, Florida in 1974 at the age of 17 and went on to win 167 top-level single titles, which is more than any player in the Open era, and 177 double titles. Yes, friends, the legendary Martina Navratilova. Martina Navratilova is a Czechoslovak-born American former professional tennis player and coach who is considered one of the best female tennis players of all time. Navratilova was world number one for a total of 332 weeks in singles and a record 237 weeks in doubles, making her the only player in history to have held the top spot in both singles and doubles for over 200 weeks. She was year-end singles number one 7 times as well as year-end doubles number one 5 times. She won 18 Grand Slam single titles, 31 major women's double titles, which is an all-time record, and 10 major mixed double titles for a combined total of 59 major titles, marking the Open era record for the most Grand Slam titles won by one player, male or female. She reached the Wimbledon singles final 12 times and won the women's single title at Wimbledon a record 9 times, widely regarded as the best performance by any professional player at a major event. And I had the good fortune to meet Martina Navratilova when she came to Delhi, and I knew where she was staying, and along with another autograph collector, we waited in the lobby, and she came back in the evening, and we approached her, and she was very happy to autograph for us and take the photos. And I have her in my autograph collection in the form of this book. You can see it's a beautiful book written by her about her 6-step diet and fitness plan to achieve the best shape of your life. So it is called Shape Yourself. And you can see she has signed inside the book, writing, "To Pola, enjoy life, Martina Navratilova." A very, very special part of my autograph collection. Our next sports legend in my collection is also a very, very popular tennis star, this time from India. In March 2010, the Economic Times named her in the list of the 33 women who made India proud. She was also named in Time Magazine's 2016 list of the 100 most influential people in the world. Yes, I am talking about Sania Mirza. Sania Mirza is an Indian professional tennis player. A former doubles world number one, she has won 6 Grand Slam titles in her career. From 2003 until her retirement from singles in 2013, she was ranked by the Women's Tennis Association as India's number one player. Throughout her career, Mirza has established herself as by far the most successful Indian female tennis player ever and one of the highest paid and most high-profile athletes in the country. In her singles career, she is the highest-ranked female player ever from India, peaking at world number 27 in mid-2007. She has achieved a number of firsts for women's tennis in her native country, including surpassing $1 million in career earnings, winning a singles WTA title, and winning a Grand Slam title, as well as qualifying for and eventually winning the WTA finals in 2014. So far, Mirza is the only Indian female player to win a WTA title of any kind and the only to reach the top 100 singles rankings. With 42 crowns, Mirza has won more WTA double titles on the tour than any other active player. In addition, she has spent 91 weeks as the world number one in doubles. Mirza was also named one of the 50 heroes of Asia by Time in October 2005. Once again, I had the good fortune to meet Sania Mirza when she was in Delhi, and I knew where she was staying. So I met her and showed her some photographs and asked her if she can autograph them. And she looked at the photos and said, "Nice pics," and she signed them. So the item I'm going to show you from my collection is this photograph, autographed by Sania Mirza. And you can see it's a lovely, lovely photograph. And she has signed it properly. A lovely photograph in my collection. And guess what? Sania Mirza sent me this video. Check it out.
Hi, Jazzy Joe. I hear you have many feathers in your cap, from being a DJ to having the largest collection of autographed record covers. That's really amazing and so, so brilliant. I also hear you're my fan. Thank you very much. I'm flattered. And I hear you've got some of my autographs as well. So all the very best for everything. I really want to wish you the best in life and in all your adventures ahead, and good luck and keep rocking.
Wow, what a great video. Thank you so much, Sania, for your words, your kind words and your blessings. Thank you so much. It's a lovely, lovely video, and I thank you so, so much. Thank you. Our next sports legend was a right-arm pace bowler noted for his graceful action and potent outswinger. And as a batsman, he was a natural striker of the ball who could hook and drive effectively. But the biggest clue I can give you is that he was captain of the 1983 World Cup winning Indian cricket team. Yes, I am talking about the Haryana Hurricane, Kapil Dev. Kapil Dev Ramlal Nikhanj is a former Indian cricketer. He was a fast bowler and a hard-hitting middle-order batsman. Dev is widely regarded as one of the greatest all-rounders to play the game. He is also regarded as one of the greatest captains in the history of cricket. He was named by Wisden as the Indian Cricketer of the Century in 2002. Dev captained the Indian cricket team that won the 1983 Cricket World Cup. He retired in 1994, holding the record for the greatest number of wickets taken in Test cricket. At the time, he was also India's highest wicket taker in both major forms of cricket, Tests and ODIs. He is the first player to take 200 ODI wickets. He is the only player in the history of cricket to have taken more than 400 wickets, that is 434 wickets to be precise, and scored more than 5,000 runs in Tests, making him one of the greatest all-rounders. On 11 March 2010, Dev was inducted into the ICC Cricket Hall of Fame, and he has also been awarded the Padma Bhushan by the Government of India. I was fortunate enough to meet Kapil Dev in Delhi at a function. I knew he would be there, and so I took along a few items for him to autograph, and he did that very, very happily. But the item I want to show you is a very rare record. Yes, it is a record with Kapil Dev. Which one could it be? Well, it is a movie called Cricketer. Very few people know that Kapil Dev acted in the movie. He had a small role in this movie, Cricketer. And you can see at the back, his photograph is there too. It was not a huge success, but yes, Kapil Dev did star in the movie. And you can see at the back, the songs are there. The music was by DCS, that is the London group. And Kapil ji has autographed in the front of the cover, right under his photograph on the front cover. And this is a very, very special item in my autograph collection. Our next sports legend was also a part of the same Indian cricket team that won the World Cup in 1983. And is a legendary spinner. He has also accused one-day cricket, modern cricket bats, and the small grounds of causing a decline in the classical spin bowling in India. Ladies and gentlemen, I am talking about the inimitable Bishan Singh Bedi. Bishan Singh Bedi is a former Indian cricketer who was primarily a slow left-arm orthodox bowler. He played Test cricket for India from 1966 to 1979 and formed part of the famous Indian spin quartet. He played a total of 67 Tests and took 266 wickets. He also captained the national side in 22 Test matches. He finished his career with 1,560 wickets in first-class cricket, more than any other Indian. His bowling has been described as graceful, even beautiful, and full of guile and artistry. He was an expert in flighting the ball and was capable of making it hold it back or hurry forward and add subtle variations of spin. His action was so relaxed and coordinated that he was able to bowl all day with rhythm and control, a great asset to any captain. He had several very successful Test series. And once again, I was very, very lucky to meet Bishan Singh Bedi ji, not once, but twice, in two different functions. And it was a pleasure to meet him. He autographed everything that I had for him to autograph. And the item that I would like to show you is a very special item because he was such a successful spinner. So I requested him to autograph a cricket ball for me. And you can see this cricket ball with his autograph on it. A very unique item in my autograph collection, because normally, as all of you know, I collect LP records or maybe CDs or maybe photographs. But this is the first cricket ball that I have with an autograph on it, and the autograph of the great Bishan Singh Bedi. Our next popular sportsman is also from cricket and has earned 42 international centuries, which includes 15 tests, 25 ODIs and 2 T20I centuries. He was the first cricketer to score centuries in all formats of the game. Ladies and gentlemen, I am talking about the effervescent Chris Gayle. Christopher Henry Gayle, OD, is a Jamaican cricketer who plays international cricket for the West Indies. Gayle captained the West Indies Test side from 2007 to 2010. Considered as one of the greatest batsmen ever in 2020 cricket, Gayle has set numerous records across all three formats of the game. He is the most capped player for the West Indies in international cricket and is the only player to score a triplet of centuries, a triple 100 in tests, double 100 in ODIs and a 100 in T20Is. Gayle is known for his characteristic hitting, imposing physique and timing. He attributes the latter to being very thin when young and having a heavy bat. He is known for appearing very calm as the bowler approaches. He holds numerous records that reflect his batting style, including record 2020 strike rates and high scores. Gayle also is the leading run scorer for a West Indies batsman in ODI cricket. Now, it's always fun to meet Chris Gayle because he has a dynamic personality, even off the field. And I have him in my autograph collection in the form of this lovely photograph. And you can see it's an autographed photograph which has been framed, and the name has been written, personally signed by Chris Gayle. And you can see the dynamic pose. He's celebrating a victory, and it looks like he's singing a song. A lovely photograph in my autograph collection. And guess what? I told Chris Gayle to sing a song for me which would match the photograph, and this is what he had to say.
Jazzy Joe, big shout out to Jazzy Joe, man. DJ Jazzy Joe, big up yourself, man. Enough respect. You've been doing it from 1984 up until now. You're a rock star. You are a rock star. Very famous for the mixtape, Out of Delhi. But this is Chris Gayle and not Dwayne. All right? You wanted a song? Champion, champion. Everybody know say Jazzy a champion? Champion, champion. Everybody know say Jazzy Joe a champion? Jazzy Joe, all right? You're a champion. Keep doing the great stuff, all right? Love and respect every time. It's the universe, boss, all right? Jazzy Joe, I'll see you in Delhi. Respect, one love.
Now, that's what I call singing. I know that song belongs to Dwayne Bravo, but I think you did justice to it. Great, great video and a great energy. Chris, just like you are, stay like this for always, and all of us, your fans, would love you for it. Thank you for a great, great video. All the best. Thank you so much. Our journey continues with our next popular sportsman who comes from the field of hockey. He is an Indian field hockey player who played as a halfback. He was a part of the team that won the gold medals at the 1948 and 1952 Olympics. Yes, I am talking about Keshav Chandra Dutt. Keshav Chandra Dutt was one of the players from the Indian hockey team which won gold both in the 1948 Olympics in London as well as in the 1952 Olympics in Helsinki. Keshav Dutt was born on 29 December 1925 in Lahore. When Keshav Dutt was practicing in Bombay, he was asked not to return home by his family due to an outbreak of violence as a result of partition. Hence, after the historic win, he made Kolkata his home. The 1948 Olympic medal has quite a lot of significance for Lahore-born Keshav Dutt. Keshav Dutt played and contributed immensely to the most famous club of his time, Mohun Bagan. Mohun Bagan recently made news when they awarded Keshav Dutt with Mohun Bagan Ratna for his contribution towards club and Indian hockey in general. And I had the good fortune to meet Keshav Dutt ji at his residence in Kolkata. I had gone there with another collector friend of mine, a very, very dear friend and a great collector. His name is Amarjeet Singh. And we both traveled to Kolkata to meet Keshav Dutt ji. And it was great to meet him because he gave us anecdotes. He told us about the way hockey was played back then and how it has become more of an energy game now. And he showed us some artifacts from his career. And it was great because he also very, very happily autographed both of our items that we had. And I have a photograph of his in my collection, which is this one. And it's a great, great photograph. As you can see, he is smiling. A great pic from a great gentleman with a great history. Definitely a great possession in my autograph collection. And our next popular sports legend also comes from the World Cup winning 1983 Indian cricket team. The biggest clue for everyone. He is a wicketkeeper who has also been awarded a Padma Shri. Yes, friends, I am talking about Syed Kirmani. Syed Kirmani played cricket for India and Karnataka as a wicketkeeper. In 2016, he was awarded the Colonel C.K. Naidu Lifetime Achievement Award for cricket in India. Kirmani won the award for the best wicketkeeper in the 1983 World Cup. In the first round match against Zimbabwe, he equaled the then record by effecting 3 catches and 2 stumpings. Against West Indies at home, he partnered Sunil Gavaskar, who scored 236 in a record stand of 143 for the 9th wicket in the Madras Test. Kirmani was a lower order reliable batsman. During his international career, his record included 160 catches and 38 stumpings during Test matches and 27 catches and 9 stumpings during one-day internationals. Always a central figure on the field, he could dive and somersault to catch the ball and was responsible for many runouts. I had the great pleasure to meet Syed Kirmani ji at a function in Delhi. And it was really fun to meet him because he looked at the items I had for him to autograph and he told me a little bit about each of them, including a very, very special record that I had, which is this one. This is a very, very rare record and a very special one because it was specially created for the function, the live concert that happened at New Delhi on 17th August 1983, which was to celebrate India's glorious victory at the 1983 World Cup. And it was a concert by Lata Mangeshkar ji. As you can see on the record, it says the performance of the century. And it has quite a few autographs. I have the autographs of nearly the whole team on this LP record. And at the back, you can see the tracks are there. And there's a photograph of the stadium where the concert happened. And also, there is an autograph of the compere for the show, Harish Bhimani ji. But it is in the front, along with other members of the Indian cricket team, where Syed Kirmani ji has given me his autograph. Definitely a great, great possession in my autograph collection. And this is such a unique record, a big part of my collection, and a friend of mine had something to say about it. Check it out.
Hello, Mixmaster Jazzy Joe. You are a leading DJ in India. You've been mixing music since 1984. You've been rocking Delhi since 1992. Fantastic. I'm told you've got some amazing, amazing autographed record covers. More importantly, you're mentioned in the Limca Book of Records for the largest number of autographed record covers. That's something to be really proud of. Many congratulations. But the reason I am very impressed is the 1983 special one. That World Cup LP, which Lata Mangeshkar ji had done. Do you know the backstory? Because the Indian team did not have money. The board did not have money, rather, to pay the team. Raj Singh Dungarpur went and said 5,000 rupees for each player. Sunil Gavaskar said, don't treat us like waiters. That's when Lataji was approached. And then that Freedom Concert on the 8th, in August of 1983. You've got that original cover, autographed by every member of the team. Now, that's a fabulous, fabulous addition to your collection. Many more such to you. Many congratulations. I have also actually got a copy of that signed by Lata Mangeshkar in our museum. So, time we collaborate, champion. At some point in time, we must. But till then, wish you many congratulations and all the very best to many such endeavors.
Wow, what a great video. Thanks a lot, Borya. And yes, we should collaborate. We should come together and maybe display these records. I also have another copy of this record autographed by Lataji too. So we should get together soon. But till then, I thank you so much for this video message. Thank you very, very much. Amazing message. Thanks a lot. Our next popular sportsman is also a cricketer who was also a part of the World Cup winning cricket team in 1983 and is today an Indian politician. Friends, I am talking about Kirti Vardhan Bhagwat Jha Azad, or as he is popularly known, Kirti Azad. Kirti Azad is a politician and former cricketer who played 7 tests and 25 ODIs for India between 1980 and 1986. He was an aggressive right-hand batsman and a quickish off-spinner. He was a surprise choice for the tour of Australia and New Zealand in 1980-81, making his test debut at Wellington. He then played 3 tests without much success against England in 1981-82 and was later picked for the 1983 World Cup. In his international career, Azad played 7 test matches from 1981-83 and 25 one-day internationals from 1980-86. Though full of potential, he couldn't take his domestic performance to the international level, scoring only 135 test runs and 269 in one days. He picked 3 and 7 wickets in the two forms respectively. He followed his father Bhagwat Jha Azad, former Chief Minister of Bihar, into politics and was elected to Parliament on a BJP ticket but joined the Congress on 18th February 2019. I met Kirti Azad ji at his office in Delhi, and I had gone there with some items for him to autograph, and I gave them to the secretary and I said, if you can get these autographed. So he went and showed the items, and Kirti Azad ji told him that please call the gentleman who has come to get these autographed, because some of them were unique items, like the record that I just showed you with all the players autographed from the 1983 team. And there was also another unique item which I would like to show you. It is this one which he autographed, and you can see it's a very, very unique item. It's a mini bat specially used for autographs, and Kirti Azad ji has signed on it writing, to Jazzy Joe, best always, Kirti Azad, 25th January 2016. And we have saved a great sportsperson for last. In fact, our 10th artist in this episode is famous for her perfect 10 score in the Olympics at the tender age of 14. Yes, I think most of you have guessed that I am talking about Nadia Comăneci. Nadia Elena Comăneci is a Romanian retired gymnast and a 5-time Olympic gold medalist, all in individual events. In 1976, at the age of 14, Nadia was the first gymnast to be awarded a perfect score of 10 at the Olympic Games. At the same Games, that is 1976 Summer Olympics in Montreal, she received 6 more perfect 10s for events en route to winning 3 gold medals. At the 1980 Summer Olympics in Moscow, Nadia won 2 more gold medals and attained 2 more perfect 10s. During her career, Nadia has won 9 Olympic medals and 4 World Artistic Gymnastics Championship medals. Nadia is one of the world's best-known gymnasts and is credited with popularizing the sport around the globe. In 2000, she was named as one of the athletes of the 20th century by the Laureus World Sports Academy. She is also credited as being the first gymnast to perform a double twist dismount. Unfortunately, I have not met Nadia yet, but I do have her in my autograph collection in the form of a lovely, lovely photograph, which is this one. And you can see it's a photograph of her performing, and she has signed at the bottom of the photograph. And once again, it's a proud position in my autograph collection. And just to make this episode a perfect 10, Nadia also sent me a video. Here it is.
Jazzy Joe, this is Nadia Comaneci. I would like to send you all the best wishes and many virtual hugs. I hope you are well where you are and stay safe. Congratulations on your amazing work. The largest collector of autographs. I wish you all the best. Continue your work and thank you for being a fan.
Now, that's an amazing video. Thank you so much, Nadia. Thank you so much for your words and your wishes. An amazing video. I thank you so much. Thank you. And now, we come to the end of this episode featuring autographs of popular sports legends in my collection. I hope all of you enjoyed the information and the autographs and the videos. And if you did, please do subscribe to my channel and do like and share this video so that I can make many more like this in the future for you. Thanks for watching and stay tuned for more. You can also send any questions, suggestions or feedback to this email, jazzyautographs@yahoo.com. To all my autograph collector friends, happy collecting. And to everyone else watching, thank you so much. Hope to see you soon in the next episode with 10 more autographs from 10 more celebrities based on a theme. Till then, take care and all the best.